of course, as the character, as Robin, it's a whole host of things. It's loss. It's incorporating the loss of one's former connection to the world, i.e. the body, because he was a very athletic man. He was a very physical man, wasn't he? And an extrovert and a leader and a kind of, the leader of the tribe, really, and an adventurer. So what happens when that primary source of communion with life, with people, with the world, with nature, gets taken away without any control? So, of course, it's a very complicated process that is impossible to fathom, you know, the stages of grief when you lose something that you love. It's a loss of self in some way. And then of course he through the love of his wife and I think his own inner resources, he managed to find a way to live such a life of fullness and joy. But as a performer, as an actor, I have to say I found it very, very pleasurable to be limited. It was very strange. I thought it would be dreadful, and of course, in moments it was. But ultimately, I felt very grateful that I got to have that experience for a brief period of time to empathize as deeply as possible with that experience. What a gift it is to be an actor that gets to, you know, step in other people's shoes in that way. And increase empathy in that way. But also, there was something delightful and strangely enjoyable about being depotentized, about having your power totally having to surrender to your limitations. And I think that was a wisdom that I think Robin probably got to pretty early on with Diana, and enabled him to live in a very, very full way by accepting the limitation, and also not accepting the limitations within those limitations that other people were putting onto him. He thought, well, I know I can't control this, but I know I maybe can control something else. And I thought, yeah, that's very, very beautiful.